children.
We were cheated.
The sign. Show us the sign.
That's right.
Why don't you leave them alone? They're only children. Go on, go away. Go on.
Show us the sign.
I want to tell you that the war is going to end soon, and the soldiers will return to their homes. Do not fear. In the end, God will triumph.
You said you'd tell us who you are.
I am the Lady of the Rosary.
Queen of the Most Holy Rosary.
Where's our Lady? We haven't seen her.
A child talking to the empty air.
We saw nothing, heard nothing.
Some sort of miracle out of the hat, or this farce will become a tragedy.
Well, I can't say we didn't try to stop it.
We've been cheated. We've been lied to.
Nobody talks to the children.
Holy Mother, you promised to give us a miracle so the people will believe us.
The people of Fatima in 1917 erected this simple arch. There now stands a magnificent basilica. And on October 13th, 1951, a million people from all over the world gathered here to do homage to Our Lady of Fatima.
Glory.
square of Fatima is alive with a million white handkerchiefs, waving an affectionate greeting to the White Lady of Peace.
As I stood there on that altar, overlooking that great crowd of 1 million people, all of them waving the white handkerchiefs as white flags of purity, in tribute to peace and to the Lady of Peace, my mind left that white square and went to the red square of Moscow, where there were red flags dyed red in the blood of the victims. Somehow I felt that on this day, there was the great crisis between the white square of Fatima and the red square of Moscow. Somehow or other, one felt certain and secure about peace. If we could just magnify this crowd and these petitions and this spirit throughout the world. And in my imagination, I could see a great change coming over the hammer and the sickle. I could see that hammer that had beaten down so many homes and profaned so many sanctuaries. I could see it being held aloft by millions of men and looking now like a cross. And that sickle, which the communists use to cut human life like unripe wheat, I now saw as changing its figure and its symbolism and becoming, as the book of the Apocalypse said, the moon under the lady's feet. This is the way to peace. World War II need not have happened if men had returned to God. World War III need not happen. And it will not happen if we as a nation return again to God. If there is a Cold War here and a Cold War anywhere else, it is because our hearts and our souls are not on flame with love of God.